Turancan Salur. You are the business development manager for BiTaksi. Talk to me a little bit about the technology.
So we use mobile technology to basically pair passengers with drivers. Now, this is a platform business, and both people are mobile, so GPS is very important for us. So our app is available on Android and on iOS devices. And using our algorithms, we pair the passenger with the driver that can arrive to the passenger in the closest amount of time. So we take into account traffic, one-way streets, and using all of that, we want to create the best taxi experience for the passenger.
In terms of you're based here in Istanbul, you started the company here in Istanbul just in last March when you launched the app. What are some of the challenges to working in a city like this, especially with the traffic?
Yes, traffic is a big issue, but even bigger is that Istanbul is a city on two continents. So you have an Asian side, you have a European side, and the European side is actually split into two by the Golden Horn. So rather than one 15 million population city, Istanbul is three different cities with 5 million population each. So because we don't have that central structure like London or Moscow, drivers from one part of the city actually don't tend to go into the other part of the city. So in order to create drivers everywhere simultaneously, that was a difficult task, and our sales team really did a good job getting drivers everywhere.
Talk to me about the technology, how it's changing and what other uses it can be put to.
Well, this kind of technology can practically be used for anything. So we can provide on-demand delivery service, on-demand dry cleaning, and basically anything that you can think of. We can have mobile payments where you don't even have to go to the cashier. You can pay in-store with your credit card, and this will be actually a lot cheaper than waiting for the cashier or the waiter to come serve you.
So are you guys looking into other areas in terms of expanding the business?
Well, in the upcoming months, we're going to really look at other opportunities and other methods that we can grow our business. But our main concentration right now is on the taxi model firmly, because we still have so much to do in Istanbul. In a city with 15 million population, we still have a long way to go.
Now, I know that the idea for BiTaksi was your dad's, but talk to me a little bit about your role.
Okay.
Because it's a generational gap as well, is it not?
Yes, there's definitely a generational gap. And my father has a lot of years of business experience, obviously, which is something that I don't have. And it was really good to work alongside him and to see his experience and the way he deals with stuff, whether it's politics or business meetings. And I'm focused more on the numbers side. I like statistics. I like looking at different ways in which we can make our business more efficient. So the business development side of the project is what I mainly focus on, and looking at new partnerships and the new ways to increase our customer base.
So really, BiTaksi is a family affair.
It is a family affair, basically, and that's nice. It's nice working father and son, and it's definitely enjoyable.
What are the biggest challenges in that relationship then?
Well, usually there's no such thing as outside the business, so when we go home, we talk business also. So sometimes, you know, we can have different opinions, and you know, that might lead to arguments. But as the son, I have to respect what my father thinks, and so
we know who
so,
wins.
So you learn to accept.
Turancan, thank you so much for joining CNBC.
Thank you.